Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of OMSI 2 Bus Simulator. Today, we're going to be doing a long haul run, as I do have the Hertfordshire left-hand path map, as I've never played this map before, so it will be interesting. I'm using my favourite bus. Again, I do not have any Arriva liveries for this bus, so this debranded Reading Buses Royal Blue livery will have to do. And today, folks, we're going to be doing the Route 300 to St Albans via Welwyn Garden City. And anyways, let's just jump in the cab. I have set up everything ready to go, as you can tell, folks. I'm just going to turn on the navigation and just hide the menu, okay? So I just pan down. Here is our calling points. I'm hoping this map has navigation so that I do not get lost on the way. And without further ado, let's get started, as we are due to go. So I don't want to be late, as I may get moaned at by the passengers. And let's start our journey. Okay then, folks, hopefully third time lucky. As you know, I don't know this map at all, and I've just got two dead ends already, so hopefully this will take us somewhere, unless I was supposed to turn around and go back. But if no joy here, I will just try doubling back on myself and see where we go from there. But anyways, apart from that, I do like this route. This map looks well made so far, but I will give my final opinion once I get to St. Albans, okay? I'm going to be honest with you, folks. I have absolutely no idea where the heck I'm supposed to go, as it's not clearly marked, as you can see there. The navigation is definitely not the best, but I do like this map though, so not all is lost, and hopefully I can find the correct path to carry on from here onwards to St. Albans. So what I'm going to try here, folks, if I can, I'm going to take the right turn and then a left turn if I can, just to try and get back on track, you know. I believe this could be the correct turn, as that's just a dead end straight up there. So I think this is the correct route onwards to St. Albans. But if not, then I don't know, because it's not very clearly marked, you know. Okay then, folks, another dead end, so I'm gonna have to double back on myself and try and find the correct road, as again there's definitely no route markings and stuff. So how on earth am I supposed to know where to go on this map? It's all ground making a nice high speed map, as there is a nice balance between country roads and city and town driving and stuff, but where on earth am I supposed to go? I need to get to St. Albans, so I'm trying to find the correct road to take here. So I definitely wouldn't recommend this for beginners. Not sure if I'm supposed to go down there or not, but so forth, it's just been mostly dead end roads. So I'm going to try again and find another turn. Well, the good news is we do have some more passengers on our bus, but that's no good if I can't find the correct road to take towards St. Albans, you know. So I'm really struggling here to try and find the correct exit. Although most of these roads are dead ends, but it's not this part of the road that confuses me. And these jaywalkers are certainly not helping things either. So that's my critics about this map. Very poor navigation. And to be honest, although the assets and everything is nice, some navigation points would be grand. Although it does tell me to go down here. And we do have some more passengers, which is a good thing. But I need to try and find my way to St. Albans so I can finish this let's play. I'm going to try an experiment, folks. I'm going to take this next turn, or possibly the next one after this, as I am certain that there should be a main road somewhere around here that I'm supposed to take. I really have no idea. So I'm going to follow that car, just in case I was supposed to turn left here. I'm really struggling to find the correct road. But I have found a bus stop, so maybe I have found the correct way. So therefore, maybe I've found the correct road towards St. Albans after all. But I'm just going to have to guess which one is the correct road to take. So just bear with me, okay? I believe this is the underpass that will take us back to the bus station. But as you can see back there, folks, most of these roads are dead ends. So I'm going to have to try and find my way back onto the bus route or something. But anyways, I'm going to skip the bus station this time, folks. So we'll just have to see where I'm supposed to go. But hopefully I should be able to get to St. Albans. But if not, then actually, folks, I think we might be in luck here, as I've just seen the marker, which I think takes us this way. So that's not too bad. Hopefully we're not going to get lost again. But nonetheless, it's still a nice route. I do like the balance between city driving and high speed driving as well. And I certainly recommend having a go. Although I wouldn't recommend this map for absolute beginners, as I'd say the skill, I'd say the skill level is probably more of a medium difficulty, as the navigation points are not really clear compared to some of the other maps that I've played in previous Let's Plays, you know. As you can see ahead, folks, we have two Arriva buses that have caught up with us and have overtaken us due to me getting lost. But thankfully, that tunnel cut out half of the route just so I could take a shortcut to get back onto the proper path. But at least I now know to take the third right from the bus station and not go straight. But to be honest with you, those arrows at the turns, at the roundabouts, they're not really that clear, and it's easy to get confused of if you should go straight or turn right. And it was just by pure luck that I found the third marker, otherwise I probably would have abandoned this Let's Play. But if the creator or someone were to put better navigation points, I'd definitely recommend this for any difficulty. But skill level for this one, I'd say it's a medium. I'm not sure what's going on here, folks, but I'm just going to cut this queue up, as for some reason. We do have two buses conflicting with each other. I have no idea what's causing that, but we won't be able to go anywhere if I don't do something. But anyways, that'll give me an opportunity to pick up some passengers, if there's any at these bus stops, of course. That is really annoying. I really dislike that feature about this map. Jaywalkers, as you know, I was trying to catch up the last time, but unfortunately, a jaywalker just walked out in front of me and there was nothing I could do. So that's the only thing I dislike about this map. But other than that, everything else, I definitely do like it. And if I was to give it a mark out of 10, I'd probably give it a 7 out of 10. For the reasons being, the only negatives about this map is that the navigation points in some areas are not very clear, and jaywalkers, that is quite an annoyance for this map, to be honest. But other than that, I do like the scenery, and I do like the custom cars and stuff that comes with it. So I'll definitely recommend it, but just beware of jaywalkers, as they just walk across the road without warning, which is possibly, and it definitely is an annoying thing for me, as I don't like to hit anyone. So the only workaround for me, when I do another let's play on this map, I will turn off the, as I was saying, I will turn off the collisions entirely, just so that I don't get any penalty points for any collisions at all. Not sure what's going on there, folks. Why on earth are the AI buses having a, what I'd call a Mexican standoff? Of which, that bus should be clearly on this side of the road, not on that side of the road, you know? So why on earth they're having a standoff for is beyond me. Maybe there's some pathing issues that need to be fixed on this map. So I'll try and find some patches for that, but the buses are not supposed to be standing off against each other, because that's twice that's happened already now. As the last one was back at Welwyn Garden City. But anyways, hopefully we shouldn't be too far away now from St. Albans, where I will finish this let's play. As you can see there, folks, we've just picked up some more passengers from Hatfield as we make our way closer towards St. Albans. As you can see there, folks, another annoying jaywalker just walked out straight in front of my bus. That is really an annoying feature about this map, as I've never seen as many jaywalkers on any other of these maps I've played on OMSI 2 in the past, as many as I do see on here. I couldn't even stop in time either. But anyways, I'm gonna make sure I've got the right turn. Of which thankfully I have. As I was saying there, thankfully I have. And we have got some more passengers to pick up as well. And we're just coming into Hatfield Town Centre. Thank you. Well, there is something unique about this map. We do have some magic floating in the air passengers. So, one thing I can say, folks, this map does have some unique features about it. It does have floating passengers, suicidal jaywalkers, and traffic that doesn't always give way to you. So, whilst I can live with the traffic not giving away, I would recommend turning off all collisions when playing this map, okay? As to be honest, I do try to keep a clean track record, and I prefer my Let's Plays to go smoothly, but sadly, that's not the case on this occasion. But hopefully, we're not too far away now from St. Albans, and then I can wrap up this Let's Play and put it down to experience of bad design where the passengers cross the road, hence my complaints about the jaywalkers and stuff, you know. Nonetheless, apart from the obvious bugs, this is still a nice map to drive buses along.
Thank you.
I do hope you have enjoyed this let's play, folks. I'm not sure how far we are away from St. Albans, but I've certainly enjoyed this map overall, and it is well made. But the only thing I don't like is the e-jets that just walk in front of your bus and you don't have time to react, of which, without turning off the, as I was saying, without turning off the collisions, expect to get some penalty points on your report. So I'd highly recommend turning off the collisions if you can, okay? But anyways, I don't think we're too far away from St. Albans, folks, but I will wrap this let's play up and put it down to experience once we get to our final stop on this route, okay? Right, folks, I think we're going to call it quits here, as we have Reece and Albans, and I'm now on the bus stand and stuff. And to be honest, mixed feelings about this map, to be honest. The good points about this map, I do like the custom assets, and it does have a nice length to it. And I believe this map is possibly one of the longest I've actually played in OMSI 2 entirely, as there is a nice balance between town, city, and high-speed driving. So you do get plenty of opportunities to thrash your bus and also to test to see how much power the bus you're driving actually has. And to be honest, folks, I do like the Alexander-Dennis Enviro 400 MMCs. Although this route is very well made, at least in my opinion, I do like the customized cars and the buildings and the assets and that. My bugbears and my absolute dislikes about this map is the jaywalkers, because I got next to no warning, hence the reason my two pedestrians went underneath my bus. And to be honest, I really don't like that. This is OMSI 2, not Grand Theft Auto, you know. But that's just my two cents on that. There's a couple of bugs on this route where there was a couple of standoffs between the buses, as that shouldn't be happening. And I've never seen that before on other maps that I've played. But I do believe this used to be a right-hand drive map that's been converted to a left-hand drive map. So there might be a few bugs and possible pathing issues that could possibly be fixed. And maybe there's a path that I'm not aware of. But the jaywalkers, that's a big no for me. So, to be honest, would I recommend this route? Absolutely. But one thing I would add to that, turn off all collisions, as then you won't get any penalty points for any collisions at all. Especially between jaywalkers and your bus. Because to be honest with you folks, that's not exactly funny, or at least in my opinion. And as I said before, this is not Grand Theft Auto. This is a bus simulator. But anyways, enough of that for now. I just want to say to you, if you made it this far into the video, a big thank you for watching. And as always, folks, I do appreciate all your positive and constructive feedback. Until next time, have a good week or weekend. Take care. All the best. And God bless. And I will see yous in another video coming soon. Okay, folks? Take care of yourselves. And I will see you later. Cheerio.